Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through some examples for the selection of both a high pressure valve and a gas bypass valve for a transcritical refrigeration application. Coming up, selecting a transcritical high pressure valve, selecting a transcritical gas bypass valve, generating a report, as well as generating a bill of materials. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the Cool Selector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So do check out the other videos if you haven't already. Links are in the video description below. We start the selection process for our transcritical high pressure valve by clicking on the Valves and Line Components tab and then selecting the transcritical high pressure valve option. The screen will then refresh to show our product selection. In the left hand panel, the system schematic highlights where the valve will be installed. The system has already been selected for transcritical system and the gas cooler line is chosen. The application has also defaulted to use the refrigerant CO2. We can choose the connection type we require, but for this example, we'll leave this as all. We will now define the operating conditions at the top. We'll start with the cooling capacity. In this example, we'll input the low temperature cooling capacity at 25 kilowatts, and then the medium temperature cooling capacity as 8 kilowatts. In our case, the low temperature evaporation temperature will be negative 32 degrees Celsius and a medium temperature evaporation temperature will be negative 10 degrees Celsius. We leave the superheat and internal heat exchanger efficiency as default. For the gas cooler, you can notice that the minimum outlet temperature is required as an input. The minimum outlet temperature represents the outlet temperature in winter conditions. This is because, considering a constant receiver pressure or saturation temperature, the valve opening degree increases by decreasing the gas cooler outlet temperature. In other words, the highest opening degree of the valve is at minimum gas cooler outlet temperature. So to avoid undersizing of the valve, the minimum outlet temperature is requested by the application. We'll specify a minimum outlet temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. There are two options available for the receiver conditions, the pressure or the saturation temperature. In this example, we'll specify a temperature of 2 degrees Celsius. We can then set our selection criteria based on load. The application will suggest products which best match the operating conditions and load percent. For this example, we'll leave it as 80%. In the product family section, the products which are compatible with the system definition are displayed. We can hover our mouse over the product title to display a product photo as well as a brief description. For this example, we'll select the CCMT valve. The main window will now refresh to display product information. Some products will be listed with red text. This is warning us that there is a compatibility issue with our system. In the rightmost column, you will see a warning symbol. If we hover our mouse over this, we'll be able to see what the issue is. Additionally, if we click on the product, a warning message will display above the table. You will notice that one row is highlighted in green. This is the product suggested by the application as most applicable based on the capacity and load. This is only a suggestion and you should check the performance details to decide if this is best for your system. To check the performance details, we head to the bottommost segment of the window. In the first tab titled Performance Curve, we find an interactive graph plotting the opening degree against mass flow rate. The values will update as we move our mouse across the graph. Under the Performance Details tab, we can find thermodynamic data for the system along with a system schematic and a pressure enthalpy chart. In the sub-tabs, we have system details as well as product-specific data. Under the code number selection tab, we can find the code number as well as some additional product information. We can then generate a report as well as a bill of materials which can be provided to a Danfoss supplier for a quotation. We'll look at how to do that towards the end of this video. We start the selection process for a transcritical gas bypass valve for our system with the same operating conditions as our previous example by opening a new tab and then clicking on the Valves and Line Components tab, and then we select the transcritical gas bypass valves option. Similar to the previous case, in the left-hand panel we see that the system type has defaulted to transcritical. The line where the valve will be installed in the system is highlighted and the refrigerant has been pre-selected as CO2. We could choose the connection type, but in this example, we'll leave this as all. You can notice that Cool Selector 2 keeps the operating conditions from our previous selection. This option is useful when we want to select multiple components in different lines or compare different components in the same location for our system. Additionally, you can notice that in the case of gas bypass valves, for the gas cooler operating conditions, the maximum outlet temperature is required. The maximum outlet temperature represents the outlet temperature in summer conditions. This is because a higher gas cooler outlet temperature results in a higher opening degree in the gas bypass valve as the gas fraction after the high pressure valve increases. We'll specify the maximum outlet temperature as 40 degrees Celsius for our system in this example. We can then input our selection criteria. The suggested product will be based on how closely it matches the capacity as well as the load percent. For this example, we'll use the default 80% as this gives us some reserve. In the product family section, different options for gas bypass valves are available. We can view a small photo and a brief description by hovering our mouse over each title. In this example, we'll choose a CCM valve. The main window will now refresh to display product information. You will notice that one row is highlighted in green. This is the product suggested by the application as most compatible based on capacity and load. This is only a suggestion and you should check the performance details to decide if this is best for your system. To check the performance details, we head to the bottommost segment of the window. In the first tab titled Performance Curve, you'll find an interactive graph plotting the opening degree against mass flow rate. The values will update as we move our mouse across the graph. Under the Performance Details tab, we can find the thermodynamic data for the system, along with a system schematic and a pressure enthalpy chart. In the subtabs, we have system details as well as product-specific data. Under the Code Number Selection tab, we can find code numbers as well as some additional product information. We can then generate a report as well as a bill of materials which can be provided to a Danfoss supplier for a quotation. We'll look at how to do this towards the end of the video. We can generate a report for our selected products simply by clicking on the report button in the top menu bar. The window will then refresh to display our product report. In the left-hand panel under Items to Include in the Report, we can add or remove information from our report by clicking on the plus button and then selecting or unselecting the items. If you make a change here, simply click the update button at the top to apply these changes. Additionally, we have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name to the report using the inputs on the top left-hand panel. Again, if you make a change here, simply click the update button to apply these. Along the top of the report, we also have various options to export the report. We can generate a bill of materials which can be provided to a Danfoss supplier to obtain a quotation by clicking on the bill of materials button at the top menu bar. Here, the product quantity, product description, and code numbers will be displayed. In the left-hand panel, we also have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name using the inputs. If you make a change here, just click the update button to apply this. Along the top of the bill of materials, we also have a number of buttons to export the bill of materials. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed this and it has helped you. If so, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you have any questions at all, let us know in the comment section down below. You can also find links to more CoolSelector 2 tutorials in the video description. Do check these out, and once again, thanks for watching.